Good morning to all. Very hearty welcome to my channel. In today's class, we are going to discuss about the logical operators in Python. So let's move on. So we are going to discuss about the logical OR operator, logical AND operator, and the logical NOT operator. Talking about the logical OR operator, firstly, OR operator says that expressions on either side of OR operations, if either of them is true, then the result is true. That is, if I have two expressions, A less than B or A less than C, where the values of A and A, B and C are given in this form. So we say A less than B, that is 5 is less than 6, or 5 less than 7. So 5 less than 6 is true and 5 less than 7 is also true. In this case, we get the result true. Actually, how OR works, if I have two expressions, that is X and Y, and in between we have OR. So if it says that if the first expression, that is X, if X is true, one true is enough for making this entire expression true. So if X is true, then return X. Else if X is false, then return Y. And if X is an expression, it's a really containing relational operators. So if X is true and Y is also true, then the result is true. So we'll take it in this way, X and Y. So if we can say false or false. So the first statement here, the first expression is false. If the first expression is false, it will check the second expression. Second expression is also false. That means the result is what? False. That is in case, in those cases when X is an expression and Y is also an expression. So even if there is one true, the result will be true. So this is in case of expression. So we saw over here that if A, this expression, that is A less than B was true and A less than C was also true, so the result was true. If I take another example, so I have just taken this as B less than A. So B, value of B is what? 6. And value of A is what? 5. And value of A is 5 and C is 7. So 6 less than 5 is what? False. Whereas 5 less than 7 is true. So there is one true in the statement, hence the entire result will be true. So for OR operations, one true is enough to make the entire expression true. Now there is one thing, if we are working with literals on either sides of the OR expression or of the OR operator, that is we can have numeric literals, we can have string literals, we can have complex number literals, okay, Boolean literals. So if we are working with literals, in that case, how it will work? So if we are working with literals, if our X is a literal and Y is a literal. So if X is false, if X is false in the beginning, okay. So what will happen, it will also check for Y. if y is false, that is whatever is irrespective of the value of y, it is going to print y. If x is false, print the value of y. If x is true, then print the value of x. Because one statement is enough for doing that. One, even if one of the literals is true, that means your entire result is true. So, how do we consider whether literals are true or false? So, when you have literal something like this, like if I have a numeric, an integer literal like 45, a non-zero literal is always considered to be true. Whereas a zero literal is considered to be false. So if I write here 45 or 0, so the first one is true, 45 is true and 0 is false, so the result will be what? True. And that's why, because result is true, what will be returned? 45 will be returned. So when you write on the Python console 45 or 0, this statement will return 45. Because 45 is a non-zero value which corresponds to true. If you write 0 or 7, so 0 is false. If it is false, it will move on to the second statement. And here it finds that 7 is true. So it will return 7. If I have a string literal hello and I write hello or empty literal, so hello literal will be considered as true, whereas this empty literal will be considered as false. So what will be returned? Hello will be returned, because hello is true. And if I have an empty literal followed by hello, I have written hello within single quotes. So this empty literal is what? It is false. Whereas hello is what? It is true. So the result will be printed as hello. If I have true or false, so first one is already true, so the result will be what? True. And if I write false or true, then also the result will be true. That is the second element. So this is how we can evaluate literals or expressions on either sides of or operator, which is also known as a logical operator. Similarly, let us check AND, the logical operator AND. What does AND say? AND says, first rule is, if either of the expressions, firstly I am talking about expressions, either of the expressions is false, the entire AND result is false. Let's understand this by an example. So again, I take A is 5, B is 6 and C is 7. So I write here, C is less than A and C is less than B. So what is C? It is 7, A is 5 and 7 is less than 6. So is 7 less than 5? No, it is false. If 7 less than 6? No, it is also false. False and false will give me false. If I just change the statements, A less than B and C less than B. So A is 5, B is 6 and 7 is less than 6. So 5 less than 6, it is true. Whereas 7 less than 6 is what? False. So the result will be what? False. Why? Because either of the statements, either of the expressions is false. If I just change this, if I consider literals, that is x and y, and I have x and y as the statement. So if x is true, then the result will be what? X. Sorry, one second, I'm very sorry. If x is true, it will move on to the second one, y. It will print what? Y. And if x is false, it will print x. How? Let's see. Let's take the previous example itself. I write the first one where A, the first condition is true. So A is less than B and C is less than B. So the first statement is what? True. 5 less than 6. And second statement is what? It is false. So when the first statement is true, it will move on to check the second expression. Now second expression, had it been true, the result would have been true. But it is false. So the result we are getting here is what? False. Here it is true, here it is false. So in AND, if expression X is true, return expression Y. That is it. This is X, this is Y, and we are getting what? Y. If I take the example, that is 45 and 0. So 45 is true, 0 is false. So first one is true. So answer will be 0. That is the false value. If I write 0 and minus 13. Now 0 is false value, whereas minus 13 is non-zero, hence it will be true. So first one is false. Result will be the first one. That is the false value. Same way, if I write hello and empty string, first one will be true because it's a string, and second one will be false because it's an empty string. So it will return what? Empty string. But if you write empty string and hello, first one is false, second one is what? True. So this will return what? First one is false, it will return the first one, that is the empty string. So this is how OR and work. Now we will see the logical operator NOT. Now NOT is also a negation operator. It is just used to change true into false and false into true. Whatever is true will become false. Whatever is false will become true. So if I simply write not 45. 45 is what? True. Not true. It will return what? False. If I write not single quotes, a pair of empty quotes. Empty quotes is what? False. It will give me what? True. That is the negation, the opposite of what is right now. I write 5 less than 6. So 5 less than 6 is what? True. But if I write not 5 less than 6, it will first evaluate 5 less than 6, which will be not true, and it will give me what? The result, that is false. Not true. This not works on this true and makes it into a false. So this is negation operator. So let's see some questions regarding this. So we have these two questions here. Question number 19 and question number 20. So let's check out question number 19 first of all. Given three Boolean variables A, B and C, and the values of A, B and C are also given. Evaluate the following Boolean expressions. So first one we have B and C, that is true and false. So obviously the answer will be false. Why? The first one is true, it will move on, because it's an AND operator. If the first one is true, it will also check the second expression, because for AND the condition is the criteria says that both the operands on either side of it should be true if the result has to be true. So if the first one is true, it will obviously move on to the second one also to check whether it is true or not, and because it is not true, it is going to print its value false irrespective of whatever is the value. Had it been true and true, it would have returned true because it would have written the second true, right, which is on the right hand side. And the first one is true, second one is false, it's returning false. Second is B or C. So true or false. So first, now here we have OR operator. Even if one of the expressions is true, the result will be true. So that means it will return the first one, not A and B. Now in this case, we have to take care of the operator precedence. So the precedence of NOT operator is more than that of AND. So first of all, not A will be executed. So this will not A, when I say not A, A is what it will, it is considered as a true value. Sorry, one second. Sorry, the values are given. A is what? False. So not false will give me what? True. And B, what is the value of B? It is also true. So true and true will give me what? True. Let's check this out on the Python IDLE. Yes, the answer is true. Next is A and B or not C. So what is A? It is false. And B, that is and true or not false, that is not C. C is false. Okay, so we have false. Now because we have a bracket here, we have to solve it first. So false and true will give me what? False, because the first one is false. Or not F. Now I told you that the priority of not is more. So not F will become what? True. And false, first one is false. Or true, it will give me the second one, that is true. Next is E. So E is not B and not A or C. So not B is what? True. And not A or C, that is false or false. So let's execute this one. First of all, you can see that from here the bracket will be solved. So it will be not T and not F or F. So both are false, so result will be false. Now not T and not false will be executed. So because of associativity, first this will be executed and then this will be executed. So not T will become false and not false will become true, and the result will become what? False. So I'll just take some time to delete all this. Next is the f part, that is not b or not a, and c or a. So you can see over here we have a bracket, inner bracket. So first we'll solve that inner bracket, not b or not a. So when we have this not b or not a, so we will write it as not true or not false, as we'll take the values from here itself, and c that is false, or a that is false. Now not t means false, or not f means true. Not, now f or t, so first one is false, it will return the second one, that is true. True and false or false. So I can remove this bracket from here. So now not true and false, so because it is in bracket, hence it has to be executed first, this will become false. So not false or f. So not false will become true, or false, which is equal to what? True. So the result will be true. Next is, what would the following code fragments result in given x equal to 3? So now the first part is, I'll again delete this part. Yes, so first we have this part over here, that is 1 less than x, 1 less than 3, it is true. B is x greater than equal to 4, x is 3 greater than equal to 4, answer is false. C, x equal to 3. Yes, the answer is true. D, x equal to 3.0. Here also your answer will be true, because this x will be compared with the integer value of this side. So 3.0 also is 3 only, hence both sides will be true. Next is hello equals hello. Yes, both are same, so its result will be true. Coming to the f part. This hello greater than this hello. So over here, it will always check the ASCII value, because the first one is capital H, and capital H falls within this range. So capital H will fall within this range, whereas small h will fall within this range. And you can see that the ASCII values of small h is greater than that of capital H. So over here, h will always be less than h. Hence, this result will be false. Next is g part. 4 divided by 2. Yes, it is 2.0 only. So you will get value as 2. Next is 4 divided by 2. This is also going to be true, because both are the same. Next, x less than 7 and 4 greater than 5. So this is true. This is false, because it is and in between. Hence the result will be false. So this is how we use logical operators in our